He's magus. I like his teddy bear staff, though. What is up, dudes? It's Jeremy. This is kind of a continuation from the last episode because we're just rolling right into the next mission, which I didn't even see the name for. So, stealing from thieves. This should be the last one on chapter one of the quest. So, yeah. Been having a lot of fun with this game. A lot of fun. Starting a game before anybody else gets a chance to join. Run solo. To be honest, I usually play games solo. Not because I'm not a social person or anything like that. Hold on one sec. Oh man, some thieves went inside. It's up to us to track them down. What a weird voice. Anyways, I usually play games solo because... Oh, we did get a new power. I didn't know when the last episode left off. And now I know we definitely did. So that's very exciting. Anyways. Usually play solo. Just because it's less for me to keep track of. I know it sounds really dumb, but like when I play a multiplayer game, or if I play online with some friends, like I'm trying to play online with some friends, but then there's also times when I'm just trying to kind of chill out and play a solo game and not have to worry about like what their characters are doing, if they need help. Sometimes it's exhausting just chatting for hours on end. It's ironic because I'm still doing it anyways by doing this YouTube channel. But whatever. Wow. Well, that was stupid. I'm not going back for those things. Tread on the switch. Now, what would really make me mad is if there were four switches and or two switches. And I like had to be with somebody else to get any further. It's very annoying. It happens in a lot of games, and I do not like it. The other reason that I play solo with this game specifically is because the connection, like the servers just seem to be like off. It's the only game that I have issues with. It's very weird. Dang. The guy was so anxious to get to me that he just took a bunch of spikes to the butt. Okay, cool. The Pop Diamond. Gotta get to the Pop Diamond before the thieves get to the Pop Diamond. Who the hell are you? Oh snap, who's this? Oh, they're more... Oh, they're bad guys. I thought it was someone who was gonna help me. No, they have a mage. Thankfully, he casts spells at a really slow rate, so... Don't have to worry about him taking me out. Alright, you're done, son. Now hurry up. Knocked out. Alright. Let's knock out these last few rooms. I just saw that hint about hard difficulty. And I'm wondering if I should even bother, or maybe I should just keep doing this just to enjoy the game. I suppose you could always replay missions on a harder difficulty, which I think is what I'd rather do. That way I can just kind of experience the game and the story on just a normal difficulty setting. Won't level up as fast, but that's okay, I'll come back. If I'm worried about how high my level is, I'm gonna put in a whole bunch of time into that game anyways, right? That's what makes sense to me. Maybe I'm wrong, dudes. I'm curious, I don't think I've said before since I've been playing this game, but like, usually I will, every like, maybe once or twice a year, I'll find a game that's like kind of grindy, and I'll really get into it and be all about it and obsessed with it, which that's what this kind of game is for me right now. But for the most part, I don't like games like that, so I'm curious to know if you are, if you like games that are like kind of grindy and that you have to put a lot of time into to have a decent character, or if you like games that you just play through a quest. The cool thing about this one is you don't have to be grindy. And I'm mainly thinking of like Warframe. Warframe I put tons of hours into, and it's very grindy, like you can't get very far unless you do lots of grinding. Grinding, for anybody that isn't familiar, grinding is like replaying missions just for the experience or just to level up. Mages. I like his teddy bear staff though. I need to get one of those for my mage. That's the other kind of cool thing is, even though I'm playing as a warrior, I've picked up some cool armor for my other characters. So hopefully they'll appreciate that. And hopefully it'll help them out whenever I do decide to level them up. If that's something you want to see, dudes, if you want me to stop playing as a warrior, let me know, because it's not like I'm totally against it. I just wanted to level up this warrior as much as possible. But we can do that whenever, if that's something you want to see. Alright, last room. Here we go. Why's my... Hold up. There we go. Had some screen issues for a second. Oh, snap. The pop diamond. In that treasure chest. Oh, snap. V8 Klein. Now, the last dude had his name was so... It was like Buffett. This dude, V8 Klein, that's a badass name. And he's got a blue mohawk and an eye patch. This guy's way cooler than the last one. Bombs here. Bomb rocks. Ooh, dang, that did a lot of damage. Oh, he wasn't close enough. My god, look at that. And he knows karate. Alright, let's take this dude out. Oh snap, I didn't expect it to do that much damage. That was insane. Alright. Walk away. Oh, wait a second. These are Drake Gang dudes, huh? Wait. What is going on? Oh no! Dudes, we got played. The Pencil Gang. Oh no. We got played. That's not cool. Well, that's it for the mission. I guess we're gonna have to track down the Pencil Gang. Oh wow. We got a lot of stuff here. And it looks like a pretty epic weapon. The V8 Bleeding Gate. Wow. dude, that was actually a pretty cool ending to that mission. We're gonna make sure there's nothing else. I'm sure there isn't, but I just want to be safe. Alright, so that is it. That's it for chapter one. So we're going to be moving on to chapter two. Stay tuned for that. Dudes, like I said, there's a couple questions I know I asked throughout the episode. Let me know in the comments below, or you can join us on Discord. And we will see you in the next one. I was watching to see if we made it to level four. And we will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching, dudes.